The U.S. Navy's newest supercarrier has been christened. On the 7th of December, Caroline Kennedy, the daughter of former President John F. Kennedy, presided over the christening ceremony. The future USS John F. Kennedy is the second ship to bear the president's name and the second Ford-class aircraft carrier. The ceremony was held at Huntington Ingalls Industries, Newport News Shipyard in Virginia. It's to be noted that the christening doesn't mean that the warship will be part of the U.S. Navy straight away. The carrier is structurally complete and can now float on its own, but the equipment is still to be fitted and tested. If things go smoothly, then the supercarrier will be commissioned in the early 2020s. Once completed, the USS John F. Kennedy will have an air wing of 70-plus aircraft. It will have 4 strike fighter squadrons, totaling 44 fighters. Currently, those squadrons are filled with FA-18E and FA-18F Super Hornet fighters. In the future, F-35C will be added. In addition, there will be 1 electronic attack squadron with 5 EA-18G Growler electronic attack aircraft, as well as 1 carrier airborne early warning squadron with 4 E-2 Hawkeye early warning aircraft. Apart from these, it will have 1 helicopter sea combat squadron with 8 MH-60S Seahawks, 1 helicopter maritime strike squadron with 11 MH-60R Seahawks, and 2 C-2A Greyhound carrier transports. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Ford-class supercarrier USS John F. Kennedy will be much more advanced when compared to Nimitz-class. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Nimitz-class carriers have been the face of the U.S. Navy and have enabled power projection far off from the U.S. homeland. USS Nimitz, the lead ship of Nimitz-class, was commissioned in 1975. The Nimitz-class has been able to accommodate many new technologies over the decades, but the Nimitz design has now reached its threshold, and this is where Ford-class comes in. Ford-class supercarriers are being built to replace some of the United States Navy's existing Nimitz-class carriers. The first ship of this class is Gerald R. Ford. USS John F. Kennedy is the second one. USS John F. Kennedy will utilize the latest technological advances and incorporate many improvements over the Nimitz class. With USS John F. Kennedy, the U.S. Navy will have 2 state-of-the-art supercarriers with another 3 in the pipeline. Nimitz-class supercarriers got planes moving for takeoff using steam-actuated catapults. The system required a lot of steam piping, a large condensate return, and tons of fresh water. They also have a lot of maintenance issues. Plus, with steam actuation, the majority of the force is being transferred to the airplane at the beginning of the stroke, in a jolt. This puts stress on an airframe, and thus reduces the lifespan of the expensive planes. USS John F. Kennedy will use the Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System, EMALS. The system uses a linear induction motor with an electric current to generate a magnetic field. That field then propels a carriage down a track. Since the power delivery is linear, it negates the deficiencies of a steam catapult and is more suitable for future aircraft and drones like MQ-25 Stingray. 4 of these EMALS will be present. 2 will be at the bow, with the other 2 at the port side, enabling the simultaneous launch of 4 aircrafts. American Nimitz aircraft carriers, the French Charles de Gaulle, the Russian Kuznetsov, the Brazilian Sao Paulo, the Chinese Liaoning, and Indian Vikramaditya uses the hydraulic arresting system, which is a dated system and suitable for only traditional carrier-based aircraft. USS John F. Kennedy will be fitted with advanced arresting gear, AAG. AAG is capable of working with all current and projected future carrier-based aircraft, from the lightest unmanned aerial vehicles to the heaviest manned fighters. The heart of any aircraft carriers are the nuclear reactors, which provide the required power. The Ford class has newly designed reactors. Two Bechtel A-1B nuclear reactors will be installed on USS John F. Kennedy. Each of these are capable of producing 300 megawatts of electricity, triple the 100 megawatts of each Nimitz-class vessel. The huge power supply provides for the legroom required for future expansions, like inducting lasers and electromagnetic railguns. U.S. military has been working on these two technologies for some time now. USS John F. Kennedy will be equipped with the most powerful radar to be ever fitted in a warship. It will have an integrated, active electronically scanned array search and tracking, AN-SPY 3 radar system. The AN-SPY 3 is manufactured by Raytheon and designed for both blue water and littoral operations. In general, ships have different radar for different purposes, like one for scanning large areas and another for target engagement. These are integrated by the ship's combat system. But AN-SPY 3 is different. It's a dual-band radar, DBR, that utilizes a multi-tier dual-band tracker, which consists of a local X-band tracker, a local S-band tracker, and a central tracker. The X-band tracker is optimized for low latency to support its mission of providing defense against fast, low-flying missiles, while the S-band tracker is optimized for large area coverage. The central tracker merges the two signals to provide a comprehensive situational awareness. So the ship's combat system will receive a single stream of data and won't have to merge them, as the radar will itself do that work. This new system has no moving parts, therefore minimizes maintenance and manning requirements. The radar helps with maintaining the stealth profile of the warship, as it has fewer antennas and is flush mounted on the superstructure. Because of better integration, the AN-SPY 3 has faster response time, and it better utilizes the power and bandwidth of the ship. USS John F. Kennedy has a newly designed deck. It has three aircraft elevators that are more efficient when compared to four in Nimitz-class supercarriers. Reduction in one aircraft elevator has freed up space, which will enable faster maneuvering of aircraft in the deck. With this space for flight deck, operations and aircraft maintenance is increased. There are several other smaller but consequential enhancements. These changes are expected to significantly improve the sortie rate. The max sortie rate is expected to be in the region of 160 flights per day for 30 days, with a surge capacity of up to 270 in one day. This will boost the mission handling capacity in a big way. Ford uses extensive automation, and this has jacked up initial acquisition cost, but this will help to reduce the future operating cost. For example, Ford-class carriers need a total of only 2,600 sailors, about 700 fewer than a Nimitz-class. Considering the 50-year lifespan of the carrier, this will translate to billions of dollars in savings. This will also mean that there will be a lesser chance of any issue or accidents due to human errors. Viewers may note that recently the U.S. Navy has suffered a series of setbacks due to collisions caused mainly due to human error. USS John F. Kennedy will be much more nimble and efficient.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.